Optiven is an audit company. We are now celebrating our 15 years. But when we started, we were not doing real estate. We started with the supply of stationaries. But when I resigned from my UN job and I joined the company in full-time basis, we started doing real estate, and we decided that real estate is so huge, so you cannot do everything. You know, we decided to do value-added plots, whereby we buy a project, you know, put infrastructure in that project, we put the water systems, we drill the boreholes, we plant the trees, we have a very strong policy on greening, and also we develop infrastructure, then register those controls, do the house designs, so when you come, you just come with your fundi and construct your own house. So that is what we do. So 99% of our time, we do value-added plots. Other than that, there are people who bought our properties 5 years ago, and now they are doing construction. They tell us, George, you are very good people. We were happy to deal with you. Can you do a house for us? So what we are doing now is to build houses for those clients that bought properties from us. And they are happy with us because as Optiven, we are guided by core values of professionalism, innovation, honesty, and good customer service. So of course, when we started, we were baptized by fire because we bought a property, it was not a clean property. So we lost about 5 million. So for 1 year, it was a year of depression. We were depressed, we were stressed. You know, when they followed up, the guy switched off the phone, they closed the office, and they were nowhere to be found. Today, 6 years, I've never found them, those guys. And remember, this money was my all savings when I was working for World Vision, I was working for UN, I was working for Lutheran at Kakuma Refugee Camp. So all my savings went, and life was very difficult. At one point, I said, I think, George, now you better go to work. So I started now doing applications. So one of the applications I did is to become a lecturer at Daystar University, where I lectured for 1 year. Of course, the money I was getting was not enough even to feed my family, to fuel my car, and life was difficult. But I said, don't give up. You know, as an entrepreneur, you have to encourage yourself. You have to keep moving. You have to put energy in you. And I said, George, wake up. Forget about the failure, because the failure taught you how to be a better person. So I said, once again, I'll start again. We went to property again. And God has been so faithful. We have now done quite a number of projects, and we have not encountered conmen. Maybe because we pray. The other day I went to Istanbul, and I saw this town. The town is 153 kilometers in length, 16 kilometers in width. So you can pick our Nairobi and drop it there. And the whole place is full of houses, you know, tall ones, taller than our KICC. So when I hear people talking about property bust, just because somebody passed through Lavington, Kileleshwa, and they saw a house to let, they think there's a property bubble. That's a lie. Why are Chinese coming here to invest big? Why are people from Taiwan coming here? Americans, they are here. The other day I went to Intercon. I found 500 Germans. The core business, real estate and oil and gas. George Washuri for Optiven and others, they are sleeping, they are saying property bubble. We Kenyans, we better wake up. There's a lot of opportunities. Look at the flagship projects at the Vision 2030. You know, the lab set, the opportunities that are going to open up. And remember, real estate follows infrastructure. Once the government implement these flagship projects, the lab set, the expansion of Kenya ports, you know, the Konza city, let me tell you, we have a lot to do in real estate. So those out there saying that there's a bust, wait for it. You'll wait for 200 years.